attack on civilians, but tensions are also rising on the other side of the world as North Korea reacts angrily to the deployment of a U.S. carrier force towards the Korean Peninsula. We're back with Congressman Adam Smith of Washington State, the ranking Democrat on the House Armed Services Committee. I want to get to North Korea in a moment, Congressman, but just moments ago, Fox Business released an excerpt from an interview that they just did with President Trump on Syria. Let me play the clip for you.
We're not going into Syria, but when I see people using horrible, horrible chemical weapons, which they agreed not to use under the Obama administration, but they violated it.
They said they got rid of them.
Hey, look, what I did should have been done by the Obama administration a long time before I did it. And you would have had a much better, I think Syria would be a lot better off right now than it has been.
Although I want to point out, back in 2013, when the Obama administration did not respond to the use of chemical weapons with a military strike, he did at that time tweet, he was a private citizen, "What I am saying is stay out of Syria." He also tweeted, "Rebels just as bad as the regime." He said, "Stay out of Syria." Now he says the Obama administration should have moved. What's your reaction to all of this?
Well, first of all, I hope at some point President Trump realizes that he is in fact president and should take responsibility for what's going on instead of continually blaming other people for everything, most notably President Obama, but certainly he blames others. So that's the first point. And the second point is I hear what he's saying about the chemical weapons, but Assad has murdered and butchered his own people with conventional weapons as well, and that is extraordinarily problematic. And what is the Trump administration going to do going forward? If Syria continues to use chemical weapons. I mean, I supported the strike. I think it made sense to respond that way, but we also have to be mindful of the limitations of that. It didn't do too much damage to Syria, and we still don't have a clear policy from the Trump administration about how they plan to work towards an alternative to Assad. And I certainly don't want the policy to be what it had been prior to this chemical weapons attack from the Trump administration, which was basically, well, Assad's okay because he's with us on fighting ISIS. That is not the case. We need a different policy.
Let me talk about North Korea with you for a moment. You're in Seattle, Washington. The former CIA director, Michael Hayden, has said soon, he says, within the next few years, North Korea will be able to reach Seattle with a nuclear weapon. North Korea warned it is ready to react to any mode of war desired by the U.S. Those are their words. If the U.S. were to make some moves toward a preemptive strike, how serious is a threat like that from the North Korean leader?
Well, I think the threat's very serious. North Korea, obviously, they're an incredibly dangerous country. The fact that they already possess nuclear weapons makes them even more dangerous. You have an unbelievably unstable leader in Kim Jong-un. What I'm worried about is I don't want us to miscalculate and do something that would prompt a reaction. Look, North Korea already has nuclear weapons. They are already a threat to the international community. The best way to contain them, in my mind, is to make deterrence absolutely clear, that there are lines that if they step over in terms of attacking South Korea or Japan, anyone in the region, much less us, then we will obliterate them. Because the one thing about Kim Jong-un, he is not suicidal. A part of the reason he's building all these weapons, the nuclear weapons, testing missiles, is he wants to discourage anyone from trying to take him out. And I think what we have to make clear is he cannot attack any of his neighbors if he wants to survive. I don't want us to do something premature. I mean, given the nuclear weapons he has, and even given the conventional weapons that are already trained on Seoul, a city of around 14 million people. So any kinetic action on our part, trying to prevent him from getting further down the line with ballistic missiles, I think is more likely to have worse consequences than if we simply maintain a very strong deterrent posture.
Yeah, his conventional military capability is enormous, just north of the demilitarized zone. He's got 1 million troops, thousands of artillery pieces, missile launchers, and Seoul, as you correctly point out, a huge city only about 30 miles south of the DMZ. The stakes clearly are enormous. Congressman, thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Wolf. I appreciate the chance, as always.
Coming up, more on the American warships approaching the Korean Peninsula as North Korea is raising the specter of nuclear